Hey everybody, and welcome to a new episode of The Justin Show. This is kind of cool because it's the first review of 2018. That's right, the first review. And what am I going to talk about? Double Dragon 4 on PS4. Funny how that works. Ooh, look at this close-up. Ooh, yeah, look at this case. Yeah, it's sleek. It's stylish. Hey, get that out of my face. Stop, you're moving. Stop zooming in. Stop. Now, first off, I just want to point out that this is a limited runs game edition, aka limited run, limited. There's only so many of these that were made, like you, and they're gone. This actually comes in a cool physical case. It's got a full color, I can't remember the word. Instruction manual, yes, colored instruction manual and everything. But this is a review on the game itself, and this has been out for a while on the PlayStation Network. Well, what are my thoughts? Here's the synopsis. A new threat has risen in the form of an evil gang known as the Renegades. Their only goal? Put an end to Billy and Jimmy Lee once and for all. Can you defeat the Renegade? I mean, that's pretty much it. As far as games of this nature go, and especially the Double Dragon games, they've got a story, but it's not really why you play these games, right? You play them to beat the crap out of other badass punks, right? And so the interesting thing about this game is Arc System Works actually designed this and developed this to make it and mimic it just like the older games. So we're talking retro graphics, 2D side-scrolling, and nothing fancy. It looks like as if you were to pop in a Nintendo cartridge that said Double Dragon 4. So, oh, yeah, I went to the store and I found this hidden gem. That's not to say that this game is amazing. That's not to say that this game is horrible. I do find it interesting that a lot of people played this when it first came out and said they thought it was absolutely bad or no good. And I don't know, for me it was kind of different. I felt like this really honed in on the old type of games. I mean, maybe too much to a point. I understand. You're going through the levels just like in the old games, beating up a bunch of bad guys. Sometimes going up ladders, sometimes having to do some platforming. Overall, it's kind of a frustrating game, but I always felt that the original Double Dragon games were frustrating a bit. Now, I will say, I do think this one gets really frustrating, and I'm talking like really frustrating. Like, you get 5 credits and 3 lives per credit in one run through playing as a single player. When you get co-op, you actually get 7 credits. The thing is the game starts off really easy, and you're kind of like, man, I'm taking out bad guys easy. Bam, bam, bam. I'm Double Dragon, I'm Billy, this is Jimmy, let's do this. Then you get a little further and you're like, okay, I'm taking a couple. Okay, I'm taking a couple. Okay, I've got it though, I'm still kicking some butt, but I'm taking some damage, we got this. Then you get further in the game, I'd say around mission 7 or so out of 12, and they just kick your ass. Stop, please. The game gets a little unfair. They throw out a ton of enemies at you. There's projectile stuff going on, and it just doesn't seem like you can catch a break. If it wasn't for the ability that you could continue onward from the last prior level beaten after you lose all your credits, I don't know if I'd actually ever beat this game because it gets really friggin' tough. It gets unfair tough, and I think that's my biggest critique on this. It's friggin' tough. Graphically though, it looks cool. The sprites are big, the colorful, animated, you know, just looks like if you ripped it out of a Nintendo system, blew the cartridge out, and then stuck that bad boy in. Even so much as to say that there's like screen tearing at times. Did they do that on purpose? Or did they just not know how to develop it right? I don't know. I don't know if we'll ever find out. That aside, the music is jamming. It sounds just like a retro game, you know, the beep bop boop bop beep bop boop. There is a different mode that you can play that's not retro sounding graphics, but I don't recommend it. I didn't really like it at all. It really did a disservice to the game, actually, so keep it to the retro. So Double Dragon 4, it's colorful, it's classic side-scrolling, there's not much depth to it, and it gets really, really hard. I don't think I have much more to say about the game. It's fun. If you can find it for like $5 or $6 digitally or when it goes on sale, I think it's definitely worth the time to play through and even, you know, definitely co-op, because of course that's where you're gonna get probably the most bang for your buck out of this. As far as collecting the physical edition, unless you're a huge hardcore fan of Double Dragon, then you probably don't even need this version. This is probably, like I said, these versions now are probably gonna cost quite a bit, because once these puppies go out, they go out. You gotta go on eBay, because, you know, price scalpers. But yeah, Double Dragon 4, it got a lot of hate when it came out. I honestly really liked it for what it was and what it was trying to be. Could they have done better and maybe actually refined its gameplay, like something like Shovel Knight, which took an old idea but refined it to new? Yes, they could have. They absolutely could have. And I think for that, they should definitely take some dings on. But as far as just, if you go into this thinking, this is going to be like as if a Nintendo game, literally Double Dragon 4, just came out back in 1988 or 1989 or whatever. I mean, if you look at it that way, I don't think it's so bad. That's my thoughts overall on Double Dragon 4. It's pretty much for the hardcore beat-em-up retro brawler fans. If you're not into that, it probably won't do much for you. But thank you so much if you got to the end of this review and for watching. Go ahead and like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell if you could. This was my first review of 2018, and while it might not be a huge game, there is plenty more to come. With that said, though, this is Justin, everybody, signing off.